to be hearing from some other speakers here this morning. It won't be just me. So in the order that we'll have them at the microphone, we've got Grant Whitmore, President and Chair of the Board in Saskatoon, Kuwaka. We've got Serena Gersher, representing City Councilor for Ward 8, representing the City of Saskatoon. Our Controlling Division Manager, Roger Cordy. And representing the United Way of Saskatoon in the area, their CEO, Sean Dyer, who's going to be at the microphone a little later. So to kick this off here, what I'd like to do is give you a little bit of background about Greystone, our home center, and so on. I'm sure most of you know that this location has been associated with Saskatoon Co-op for many years, going back to the mid-1960s. This was where our Greystone Shopping Center was located for many, many years. Constructed back in around 1966 or so, and at one time food, we had fashions, we had hardware. It was a real department store for the community. Over the years, as members' needs changed and the economy kind of dictated some things for us, it changed a bit, but for many years towards the end, it was our major food store over in this side of the city. About 5-6 years ago, we looked at the facility and we realized it was pretty hard for us to continue operating the old grocery store as a modern food store. So we had an engineering review done and we learned a few things, and one of the things that we learned was that this facility would need to be replaced as a food store. When the opportunity came for us to buy the former Safeway store just down the street here at the center at Circle of 8th, well, that sort of solved the problem of how we were going to stay in the food business on 8th Street. And then we had this facility sitting vacant. And it's a great location, and we knew that something had to happen with the property. So we had the building assessed to see whether it would be suitable for a home center location. And what we learned there was that the building really had outlived itself. The facility would have cost so much money to alter it to any other purpose, it really wouldn't have been worthwhile. So we looked at our home center offering on 8th Street, and of course, we've been at our other location down the street here since 1979, a piece of property that also has been long associated with Saskatoon Co-op, a leased property. And we have heard from our members loud and clear, they really appreciated that home center offering, but as much as they appreciated the convenience, and they really spoke highly of the customer service that's always been top notch in that location, we did hear that we just didn't have the offering that that people needed today, and there was no way we were going to be able to increase our offering on that site, just not enough space. So some work was done around what it would take to build a home center in this location, and whether it was economically feasible, and as you can imagine, we got the answers that we wanted to hear, and we were able to proceed with the demolition of the old facility, the construction of this new wonderful 60,000 square foot building, and here we are today. So that gives you a little bit of background what's gone on here at Greystone over the years. So next, I'd like to thank some people without whom we wouldn't be here today. And the first group I'd like to thank is our 8th Street Home Center crew and our ABS Home and Building Supplies Division people for all of their work over the years and their very hard work around getting this site open. Starting with Doug Knowles, and Doug's here today. I know Doug was in charge of the division at that time. Jeremy Hessdorfer is our new HAPS division manager. Our site managers here, Sherry Richard and Donna Skopik, and all of the crew, not just from 8th Street, but we've had a lot of help from our other people over at the FWC Home Center as well. And boy, have they pulled it together. And of course, the building wouldn't be standing here if it weren't for the work that was done by my home office, and FCL home office that is, by our friends at AODBT, Corex Construction, the general contractor, AODBT, the prime consultant and architects, and they've designed a beautiful building and built a wonderful facility for us here today. We've had a lot of put in by our support people from SEL Home Office in the Saskatoon region. We've had vendors here day after day, co-op suppliers with their sleeves rolled up, and I want to thank you, each and every one, for all the work you've put in. And and of course, I want to thank our members, the members of Saskatoon Co-op, for your support for our organization, your organization, at 8th Street all these years, and for your patience while we were building this new facility, your patience all those years working with us in that cramped building further down the street. And thank you very much. I hope by the time you've been through the place, you'll agree with me that I think that your patience has been very well rewarded by this new facility we have. So on that note, I'd like to hand things over to Grant Whitmore.
Thanks very much, Grant. You haven't left much for me to talk about.
That was my plan.
As the board, we're very pleased to open this new facility on the east side of Saskatoon. It's certainly a needed facility. When management came with a proposal to us with the idea of building this facility, we saw this as a win-win. We know when we're moving the grocery store down the street, when that opportunity arose with the Safeway purchase, we needed to fill the gap here. And working with our partners, Grant is outlined with Federated in terms of the design and a package that would work. We are really pleased with what we've come up with here and how it can feel to be part of this community. I want to introduce some of the board members that are here today if they want to stick up their hands. Dave, Ron, Norm, and Graham, any of the other board here today? I don't think I missed anybody. But, you know, we take these decisions seriously at the board table in terms of what we're doing. We just don't do it because we want to. We have to make sure it works. And we're really pleased with what management brought to our table in terms of making this work and seeing the support, the growth and support that we'll see in the community will be great. Saskatoon Co-op has been a proud member of the business community in Saskatoon. We've been very pleased at the activities that we've taken place to remodernize some of our stores, build new stores to serve the membership in Saskatoon, and beyond Saskatoon, Warman and Martinson. And as we look also to the ag side, expanding our footprint there, as we look to build a new fertilizer facility north of Saskatoon that'll give us an all-around service to our ag members at the same time. We're more than just a grocery store, we're more than just a hardware store, we're many things to this community. We're proud to be that. And we're proud of also our contributions that we're paying back, as you'll know later on, to this community. So with that, I'm very pleased with the number of people that have turned out today. And as I say, I think especially to our staff who worked on the 8th Street store, which was maybe sometimes hazardous in terms of how things were stacked up in the shelves and how they had everything stuffed in there and they could find things. I give them great credit, and I'm pleased that we have this new facility for them. Thank you again.
Thanks, Grant. I knew I'd forget to thank somebody, and it occurred to me that the way we have our work divided up, we divide all of our locations amongst three operations managers. Jason Ryan is the operations manager. We'll give a wave there, Jason. Jason begged to have time to microphone today. I told him it wouldn't be time. Sorry, Jason. I'll go around and speak to people individually. But Jason was responsible for this project. Next, from the City of Saskatoon, please. Sir.
Good morning. I just wanted to start by acknowledging that we're here on Treaty 6 territory and the traditional homeland of the Métis. I'm pleased to be here this morning on behalf of my colleagues at Council, Mayor Charlie Clark. I'm also a resident of Greystone, so I'm especially pleased to be here this morning. I think it's great to have Co-op back in this space. We, as mentioned, we had the shopping center here previously. It was nice to be able to be in close proximity. I can go over. I was reviewing the values of Co-op, and they really resonate with me. The values of integrity develop people and community. And something that I've often talked about is the importance of strengthening and building community. And we have many communities in Saskatoon, ranging from the neighborhood level, such as Greystone, to different organizations, as well as the larger city itself. And being able to support those communities, to support our local economy and locally owned stores is an incredible, important part of that. Thanks. Just a little soft-spoken. I know that when the shopping center was here, it was really a gathering place for the community and for its members. There was lots of local residents employed, as well as just access to foods and services for our neighbors. Growing up, I spent a lot of time in the area. And so it really is great to have another place for Co-op members to gather, and it's such a beautiful place. It was great to see the covered drive-through lumber storage as I walked by, and I hear it's the only one in Saskatoon. And so I know later we're going to be seeing an example of how Co-op gives back to the community. And I really do want to thank Saskatoon Co-op for being community builders and leaders in our city. I know you've been able to help many nonprofits, as well as community groups, ranging from New Austin to community associations to the United Way. And I know that will continue to happen. So I do want to thank you for that. Welcome back to Ward 8. I know it was just on the other side of Creston here, but it's the ward difference. I look forward to being able to utilize the store as I undertake some home renovations at my place close by. Thank you for having me here.
Thank you, Serena. Our next speaker is Roger Cordy, our petroleum division manager. And if you're wondering why a petroleum guy is being asked to speak at a home center opening, it is unusual. Normally, he probably wouldn't even be allowed in the door. But he's an invited guest, and the reason we have him here today is to make a presentation. So, Roger, go for it.
Adjust the mic here. Well, we're excited to be here this morning for two reasons. One is I have a special announcement, which I'll get to soon. But another reason is to help celebrate the opening of this beautiful facility. We're very excited to be here. So to give you a little background about why I'm here. So on September 19th, we took an initiative with the community to say, offer our first ever Fuel Good Day, which is part of our greater initiative of fueling our community. So what we decided to do was put a call out to our members and community and customers to say, for every liter of fuel you purchase on September 19th at our Saskatoon Co-op gas bars, we will donate 10 cents a liter to the United Way of Saskatoon and area. And we're pleased to announce that the support was tremendous. And through the efforts of our customers and members, we're able to raise over $43,000 for the United Way. Fantastic. So I'd like to call up Sean here to accept the check from Saskatoon Co-op.
I should tell you that there is more going on here than just the presentation of a novelty check. This is about helping to rewrite the story for many of the most vulnerable people in our community. Every dollar that we collect is invested back right here in Saskatoon. United Way, its work has always been powered by the generosity of this community. And so it's with tremendous gratitude and thanks that I say on behalf of United Way and our agencies that we partner with and our own initiatives, thank you to Saskatoon Co-op. United Way leads, and this is a perfect partnership for us because Co-op leads as well. And so the strength of our two brands together is working together to help create, as I said, a new future, a better future for people right here in Saskatoon, helping kids be all they can be, helping move people from poverty to possibility, and to build strong communities, which is such a great metaphor for where we are today, building strong communities. And so again, on behalf of United Way and all of the people that depend on our work, thank you, Saskatoon Co-op. Thank you so much.
Thanks, Sean. So, folks, that pretty much brings us to the end of what we've got prepared. I would like to mention that starting at 11 o'clock, there will be a barbecue fundraiser here. And we're set up in the covered storage. Where are we at? Somebody in the covered storage, right next door here. And all proceeds from that will go to the Children's Wish Foundation. That'll run from 11 a.m. until 1 p.m. So on that note, thank you very much for attending, and happy shopping. Thanks. We're going to cut a ribbon. Jeremy and Sherry.
Thank you.